Hi, welcome to ArtC. I'm your host, Bill Horin, and my guest today is Cape May County musician Dan Barry. Dan, welcome to the home edition of ArtC.
It's an honor, Bill, to be with you again. I really appreciate it.
Dan, I honestly think the first time we met was when ArtC was filming the 2013 documentary, The Great Goshen Barn Jam at Stan Spurlock's place in Goshen, of course. One of the things that really impressed me that day was the number of talented musicians in Cape May County and the camaraderie that they showed. I mean, the way they worked together and all supported each other. I think that's great that you have that going on down there. So how long have you personally been a musician?
When I was really young, and when I lived down in the state of Texas, I was in fourth grade. My teacher's name was actually Mrs. Staff, ironically, and she was wonderful. But I played the bass violin, stand-up contrabass, whatever you want to call it, till I was in eighth grade, I think, after we moved to Colorado.
Yeah. You did tell me you consider yourself a jam musician. What exactly is a jam musician?
That's a good question. I guess the reason I like that is it's really improvisational. So I like to just take the music where it wants to go. And it's different every time I play. Literally, the songs that I do, I try to make them different every time I play.
So. Right now, we're going to do a little flashback. We're going to show a clip from the Great Goshen Barn Jam in which you were performing and, I believe, doing the audio. So we're going to see that clip now. When I interviewed you and Ed Dobbs a few years ago, you told me you weren't interested in doing performing for a living. I think that's changed. Has it changed and why?
Yeah, actually it has changed. I've had several companies. I still have them, but I put them all on the back burner when my father got sick. And after he passed, I just didn't really feel like going back into those companies at the level that I was doing it in the past. Mainly, I didn't want a bunch of employees. So I figured I'd give the music this last summer a full time agenda, I guess you could say. And what a time to do that. The bottom fell out, as you know, Bill.
You know, that's part of what I'm hearing too, is this is the time of year that musicians would make most of their money and do most of their gigs. And with what's happening, that's just changed everything. How do you think musicians are handling that, especially in Cape May County?
It's been really, really interesting. I guess about a month ago or maybe 5 weeks ago, I don't remember the exact date, Lella from the Honey Hawks, I think the way they pronounce her name is Lella Eppenbach, gave me a call and wanted me to do a live Facebook show. And I was like, yeah, okay, I don't know how to do it. And so I was the guinea pig. They threw me to the wolves, and it was a completely unusual experience. I've done several of them since then, and I still can't wrap my head around it. It is very peculiar to do that. Very nerve-wracking. And everyone, I try to help out other musicians that are doing it, and there's just no getting around it. It's just a different animal. I mean, so it's been really fun and opened up a whole new vein of creative ability or creative adventures, really.
Tell me a little bit more about that series, because I think it's very important. What's the name? I know there's like two. Aren't there two, and you're doing it like 7 days a week?
Yeah, well, Lella's doing it. I just help out. And what it started out, Exit Zero Jazz Fest, I think, came up with the idea with Lella. They wanted to do a Cape May virtual happy hour. And it's been great. Lella sets up all the musicians. And as that was going along, we started talking about doing a show. That's at 5:30 every day. So when that show's over, we wanted to parlay that into another series, which is the Cape May Sunset series. And so there's two artists every day, 5:30 and 7 o'clock. They're usually about an hour or a little over an hour. Sometimes people get carried away and we'll play for hours. Yeah. So it's very fun. There's a virtual tip jar. The first one I did, I was really moved. Most of us donate money to a charity. I'm involved with the Branches organization down here in Cape May County deals with helping out the homeless community. Phenomenal organization. I'm really happy to be part of helping them, and a lot of musicians are supporting that. Another one is Music Cares organization, and there's some other ones. Each artist can decide what they want to do, whether they want to donate part of their tips to a charity or not. So, but that has that sustained a little bit of income. Certainly not enough compared to the gigs that we were doing. But there's a little bit of money trickling in, and it's not really about the money at this point. Sure, that helps. But it's just an unusual venue or genre, or I don't even know what you call it. It's an unusual thing.
You know, I find it amazing. The more I talk to artists and musicians, even though they themselves may be struggling, their willingness to give back is just unbelievable. And the fact that so many of the musicians participating in what you're doing and what Layla's doing are giving money to charities, I just think that's wonderful. It's amazing to me.
It's an incredible group of musicians down here in Cape May County. I'm so honored to be part of these folks. As much as we're somewhat competitors, all of us want to see each other do well in this. And that happened, that happened years ago. That happened well before this. And then like Marty, Bevan Langell, she runs those Harvard Theater shows, and she gets musicians together and puts on these great concerts. Marty gets these musicians together, local Cape May County musicians mostly, and we start rehearsing again out at Stan Spurlack's barn out at Crow Creek Farm, which is now his gallery, and he's got a sculpture garden there. Well worth the visit. I'm so honored or blessed that I get to spend time out there. A lot of time out there, but we do our rehearsals at the barn. And what I usually tell people that get involved in these shows is 75% of your rewards is the rehearsals at Stan's barn. It's amazing. It's family oriented, dogs, kids, food, and we rehearse for hours. do a couple of rehearsals before each show. And they're themed shows. We've done all kinds of shows. My favorite one was the Last Waltz. We did a show on that. And we've done just a whole lot of them. So, of course, we missed out on the last couple. We were going to do The Who in March, and, of course, that didn't happen.
You know, I was lucky enough to photograph probably three or four, including The Last Waltz and Dylan and a few others. And it was so much fun to watch, to listen to photograph. I think it's such a great idea she had. And like you said, the number of musicians who participated and played together and joined in on each other's songs was just unbelievable. Do you think she's going to bring this back once we get a little more normalcy to things? Do you think she'll bring it back?
Without a doubt. It's a big part of our lives. It's just a big bucket of love. And I think most of the shows, there's somewhere between 15 and 20 musicians at the shows. And usually by the end of the show, all of us are on that little stage. It's a big stage, but it's little for 20 people.
So is there anything else you'd like to add or something you'd like to say to your fellow musicians?
You know, let's get through this thing. It's been a rough ride for a lot of us, not just in the performing arts, but all of the artist community, let alone everyone else that's involved with this viral thing going around. And big kudos to the medical community and everybody that's doing so much to get through this thing, from the people at the shopping centers. And we have a lot of gratitude for everybody that's really putting in their best foot these days, is what I'm seeing. It's just amazing. But we're ready for it to be done.
So would you mind taking us out with a song?
I'd love to.
Okay.
This has been ArtC. I'm Bill Horin. Thanks for watching. And now here's Dan Barry performing a song for us.
Thanks again for having me, Bill. Everything's okay. Bring me solemn kisses from your room. Meet me in the middle of the night. Let me hear you say everything's alright. Let me smell the moon in your perfume. Yeah. Gods and years, it will rise and fall, and it's all been something long. I sing my song and I waste my talk, and it's all been something long. The shreds of news and afterthoughts got complicated scenes. You know, we huddle down behind the lights, man, then we fade like magazines, yeah. All right, meet me in the middle of the day. Let me hear you say everything's okay. Sneak on out beneath that shining sun. Meet me in the middle of the night. Let me hear you say everything's all right. Sneak on out beneath them stars and run. Sneak on out and run, y'all. Kings and queens, we must go down behind the chandelier. We don't have to speak our minds. And you don't have to hear the shreds of news and afterthoughts. We've got complicated scenes. You know, we huddle down behind our lives and we fade like magazines. Yeah. Telling it right now, meet me in the middle of the day. Let me hear you say everything's okay. Let me see you smiling back at me. Meet me in the middle of the night. Say everything's all right. Give me some love now. Give me some of your sweet, sweet loving, girl. Give me some love in me. Love is free, yeah. No,
love is free.